Hey everyone, we're in beautiful San Diego, California at the Challenge Athlete Foundation, where my friend Jen here works, and she's the amazing photographer here and does a lot of the pictures. Can you tell us a little bit about what Challenge Athlete Foundation is all about?
So the Challenge Athletes Foundation is an organization that helps people with physical challenges do the sports or activities that they want. We help provide grants, you apply, and we help you so that you can go skiing or pay for a registration or a gym membership.
I applied for one, so I'm super excited to hear back from you guys. So we're here and we're doing a workout that's going to be kind of three different levels of how you can do the workout, and I'm really excited to share it with you guys and have my friends here who I met at the Movement is Medicine Summit in Arizona this past year. It's all for CMTers looking to get active in their life. Super cool. So we're just going to get going. We're going to start this workout. The first thing we're going to do is some shoulder rolls. So I'm going to start rolling my shoulders, and Cheryl here, she's going to be rolling her shoulders seated, and Jen's going to be rolling her shoulders as well, and we're going to go the other way. Whatever way we're going, just go the other way. As specified. Okay, and next we are going to do some marching. So I'm going to be marching with my legs, standing, and Cheryl is going to be sitting with her legs, and Jen is going to be marching with her arms.
Yes.
Good work, guys. Okay, and our next workout we're going to do is a reverse fly. So we're all going to kind of do this reverse fly motion. Cheryl's going to add a little step out in her chair, and I'm going to add a step out with a squat, which is going to look so not pretty. But that's okay, because...
Now, do we want to make sure that our arms touch each other?
Yeah, you want your arm... Well, if you're holding a weight, your arms will not touch each other, but your weights will touch each other, and then your arms will touch each other. You'll make contact. Okay. And next, we are going to do an oblique crunch. So you're just gonna hold your weight, and just crunch one way, and then crunch the other way. And Jen is gonna do an awesome diagonal overhead reach, which is gonna work the same muscle like that. You're gonna do 10 of these. We've already done a couple. You guys are doing awesome.
It's feeling good.
How are you guys feeling?
Doing pretty good.
We're like halfway through the workout.
So. It's a good stretch.
Yeah, this is a good stretch.
Yeah. Adding the weight does a good job for adding an additional stretch to it.
And next, we are going to do some starfishes. So I'm going to put the weights down. You should put the weight down.
Okay.
You are going to do... I had to do the wrong thing. So the last one you were supposed to do the oblique twist, so we're going to go backwards. I'm so sorry.
You go with the flip.
The same kind of muscle. So I'm going to have you do an oblique twist like this. Cheryl, you're going to go down and touch your feet.
Okay.
And I'm going to touch my feet standing. I'm so sorry I messed that up, guys.
No worries. There's no messing up. We're just working
we
out.
We just go with the flow here.
Okay, I have a question.
Yeah.
Now, when I'm using the chair and I can bring my legs up, I feel it more here. Is that a goal or what I want? If I have the ability, but I want my legs down to be using
to ground yourself? I think if you want your legs down to feel grounded, then you should have your legs on the ground.
But do you still get that range of
you're
movement?
Still getting the range of motion because you're kind of working out the obliques and the side muscles.
Gotcha.
So you should be okay either way. It'll probably add more if you can lift your legs. I feel like we've done 10. We talked. This is definitely a lot. Okay, so next we are going to do Russian twists. So I'm going to come down to the floor. Cheryl's going to do it here in her chair. Lean back and go side to side. And if you want to add a weight, you guys can add a weight. Jen is going to do my favorite, the washing machine. So just twisting side to side.
I'm just going to add the weight in there.
And if you guys want, there are a lot of different options. So you can lift your legs up. You can add the weight to make it harder.
Oh yeah, I feel the burn on that one.
Feeling the burn. So yeah, my legs are off the ground.
forget to breathe.
And that was definitely the time. And breathe. Never forget to breathe. So next,
whew, that was good.
We're going to do flutter kicks. This is our last workout, guys. We're doing an amazing, like, nice quick ab, raise your heart rate workout. So we're going to do some flutter kicks. So I'm going to be on the ground. Cheryl's going to be in sitting, okay, kicking her legs. And then if you guys have leg mobility, do you feel comfortable doing a flutter kick?
Yeah.
So we're going to have, she's going to, Jen is going to do a flutter kick. And then also, if you guys can't do a flutter kick or don't have leg mobility, you can also do the arms, which is going to get your heart rate up. This is something that we do in Pilates a lot. So it's just about getting your heart rate up and moving around. So we're going to do some flutter kicks here. So Jen, your dealer's choice for you.
And don't forget to breathe on this.
And don't forget to breathe, because when you're working on your abs, it's almost going to be kicked by your feet. You guys are doing so good. It's awesome.
And you want to keep your legs straight?
And you want to keep your legs, you can bend them. You don't want your back to arch, so make sure you're like actively engaging your abs. You can do it with bent knees as well, if that's easier.
And I think my body's
and this is good. Sorry,
at least with that, exercise.
I can like do more on my arms, but.
And if you guys want to do that two more times through, or work out to doing two more times through, that would be amazing. So just rewind and watch us all again from the beginning and do it all over up to two more times. And don't forget to stretch. So it's so amazing being here. Thank you for having us, Jen, at the Challenge Athlete Foundation. This is such an amazing facility. If you guys are in San Diego, check it out. Check out their Instagram at Challenge Athlete Foundation. And of course, check me out on Instagram at CMTdefy. And then also comment below, subscribe, all that fun shenanigans. And I'll see you guys for the next workout. Thank you, Cheryl. Thank you, Jen. You guys rock.
Yes. Bye.